Hey, our friends at Lightrun have dropped a new tool, which I want to share with you. It's called debug0, and I think that you are going to find it very useful. Now, if you remember from my previous YouTube videos, I did a joint workshop with Lightrun, in which we troubleshooted the Spring Pet Clinic application using the IntelliJ IDEA Lightrun plugin. What was really interesting was that we could inject logs and metrics directly at runtime without having to recompile and build the project. So when I was approached by Lightrun to review this new tool of theirs that can help Java developers troubleshoot their complex projects, I was very excited since Lightrun has a lot of knowledge in the application troubleshooting space. While this research was conducted independently and reflects entirely my opinions and conclusions, the amount of work involved in making the demo and video recording was compensated by Lightrun, so kudos to Lightrun for making this happen. So let's get started. As I already mentioned, debug0 is an IntelliJ IDEA plugin that can help you investigate various issues, like exceptions or odd behaviors that you cannot easily understand. Installing debug0 is very easy, since you can download it from the IntelliJ IDEA marketplace and it's free of charge. Next, we're going to install the debug plugin. This process is very straightforward, as you just have to go to Settings, then Plugins, find the debug0 plugin, and click Install. That's basically it. After you install it, you need to register an account. And you can use Google or GitHub authentication to speed up the process. In my case, I'm going to use GitHub authentication, as Lightrun only needs to access my email address in order to register my user account. And, of course, I have to validate my email address using the code that Lightrun has just sent me via email. So, let me introduce this code and finish the registration process. Now that the debug0 plugin is installed, I'm going to test it out on the Spring account transfer repository that I have in my GitHub account. This project is a Spring Boot application that was created to emulate how bank transfer works and test whether the default database isolation levels provide us the data integrity guarantees that are expected in order to execute the transfer successfully. In the domain model part of this project, we can find the account JP entity, which maps the IBAN number, the account holder, and the account balance. For the account entity, we also have an account repository that defines several methods, such as finding the account by its holder, reading and writing the account balance. The account repository is used by the transfer service Spring Bean, which defines a transfer method that looks like this. We want to transfer a sum of cents from one account to another. And to issue the transfer, we have to make sure that we have enough funds in the source account in order to subtract that particular sum and add it to the destination account. To test the implementation, we created a transfer service test class. Which has an init method that adds two accounts, one for Alice with a balance of 10 and one for Bob with a balance of 0. The first test resembles how we usually write an integration test for the data access layer. We start by asserting the initial balances, then we operate several transfers, each time checking the current balance to make sure that the transfer was operated successfully. When executing this test, we can see that it works just fine, meaning that we can make sure that the SQL statements are generated correctly, and both the reads and writes operations are working as intended. However, a database system is a highly concurrent environment, so a test that only checks the serial execution is not going to be sufficient. For this reason, we created the test parallel execution integration test, which operates the transfer using multiple threads of execution and logs the balances of Alice and Bob after all the transfers have been completed. If the transfer method is implemented correctly, there are three correct outcomes that we could observe. Two of the transfers succeeded, and Alice's account has a balance of 0, while Bob's account has a balance of 10. Only one transfer succeeded, leaving both Alice and Bob with an account balance of 5. No transfer managed to pass through, and Alice and Bob have the same account balances as they had at the beginning of the test method. However, when running the integration test, we're going to see that none of those three correct states matches the recorded outcome. And at the end of our test, Bob's account has a balance of 80, and Alice has an account balance of minus 70. This is definitely wrong, and luckily for us, we managed to spot the problem during testing, therefore giving us the opportunity to fix it long before reaching the production system. Now, let's see whether debug0 can spot the problem. So we're going to open the debug0 plugin to ask it why the second test execution led to a negative balance for Alice's account. Just like Juni from JetBrains, which we also covered on this YouTube channel, debug0 will start its analysis by examining the project codebase. As you can see in the debug0 panel, a debug plan is created and the first step is to analyze the transfer service test class. From the test class, debug0 inspects other relevant classes, such as the transfer service spring bin. Besides the transfer service spring bin, debug0 also finds the optimistic locking transfer service and is able to understand that this component contains a concurrency control mechanism that's not used by our test class. Right from the start, you can see in this insight message that a critical race condition is investigated in the transfer service. debug0 spots that the transfer service class uses the getBalance and setBalance methods from the account repository, so it inspects the repository class as well as the account entity. This is clearly indicated as a new step in the debug plan. We can see from the summary that this step was introduced in order to confirm the race condition that debug0 is suspecting. debug0 also scans the Spring transaction configuration to figure out which transfer service implementation is used when auto-wiring the bin in the transfer service test. You can see that it inspects the Spring component scan logic and is able to determine that the transfer service is used and not the optimistic locking transfer service class. At the end, debug0 prints a root cause analysis report with a very detailed explanation. debug0 figured out that 16 threads are operating the transfer, so Alice's account is debited with the value of 80, which is basically 16 times 5, or 16 threads that transfer the amount value of 5 from Alice's account to Bob's. Since Alice had an account balance of 10, her account now has a balance of minus 70, which is 10, the initial account balance, minus 80, the sum that was transferred out. So, debug0 is correct. That's exactly what's happening here. The technical implementation issues part states that the problem originated in the transfer method, which lacks the proper concurrency control logic that should have prevented this race condition. debug0 is also correct about the fact that the default isolation level enables this issue, although the problem is not caused by the dirty read anomaly, but by the lost update. The suggestion about set balance is also worth noting. Basically, this is how JPA or Hibernate would normally work, and optimistic locking, if enabled at the count entity level, would have prevented this issue. However, the fact that the set balance simply adds the transferred amount is not really what's causing the problem, although the naming is misleading since that's what we'd expect from a set balance method. The fact that debug0 has correctly figured this out and indicated to us that we should rename the method to better convey its purpose is very useful, since improving code readability will help developers understand the code better. All in all, I'm impressed by this report because spotting the problem in the absence of a well-known and well-documented exception or stack trace is much harder. debug0 correctly identified that the problem is caused by the check-then-act race condition, which is enabled by the default database isolation level. While you can use ChatGPT or Copilot to investigate problems, the advantage of debug0 is that it has access to your codebase. And for this reason, it can provide the proper context to the underlying LLM it uses to generate the answers. Moreover, unlike a generic code assistant, debug0 takes a troubleshooting first approach that allows us to do deep code analysis over entire chains of events that trigger the issue in question. By default, debug0 uses Claude Sonnet 4, but you can configure it to use other models if that's what you want. In conclusion, I think that debug0 is a great plugin that complements other tools, such as the AI-powered Juni from JetBrains. So, if you're a Java developer and want to speed up your troubleshooting sessions and increase your productivity, I would definitely give debug0 a try.